Now, today we will discuss about units and dimensions. Now, in earlier classes, we have studied about some physical quantities, suppose speed. Second, we can say force. Third, velocity. Fourth, acceleration. Now we know that the formula for speed, its unit is meter per second. Force, its unit is Newton. And velocity, again meter per second, and acceleration, meter per second square. Now all the units are written in SI system. Now one more concept was developed, that is based on the dimensions. Suppose we have mass, length and time. Now mass, we are just denoting it by m, length by l and time by t. So if we have to write anything and that unit is related to mass, we just write it in terms of m in dimensions, and for length l and for time t we will write in terms of t. Now we have some system of units. Suppose we have SI system, MKS system, CGS system, FPS system, and so many other systems are there. Now SI system, you know that all the quantities written here have SI units, meter per second, Newton, meter per second, meter per second square. Now in MKS system, the length is measured in meter, mass in kilogram and time in second. Similarly, in CGS unit, length is measured in centimeter, mass in gram and time in seconds. Now in FPS system, length is measured in foot, mass is measured in pound and time is measured in seconds. Now suppose if we have to write this unit of this physical quantity in terms of the dimensions m, l, t. Now the unit meter is there, meter means length. So single meter is there, meter to the power 1. So we write here l 1, and here second is there, second corresponds to time t. So we will write t, and the power is minus 1. Mass is not given here, so we will write m 0. So the dimension of speed, that is l t minus 1. M 0 means 1, so there is no need to write this. L 1, that means l, and t minus 1, that means t minus 1. L t minus 1 is the dimensional formula for speed. Similarly, it is also the dimensional formula of velocity. Now if we consider another example of acceleration, its unit is meter per second square. Meter is for length, power 1 is there, so we will write L 1. Now second for time and power minus 2, so we write t to the power minus 2, and m is not there, mass, so we will write m 0. So the dimensional formula for acceleration, that is m 0 L 1 t minus 2, or we can write it as L t minus 2. This is the formula for acceleration. Now Newton. For force, the unit is Newton. So directly we cannot relate this unit with mass, length and time. For that we know that the formula for F is equal to m a, where m is mass and a is the acceleration of the body. So mass means mass, the unit is kg, and for acceleration we have already calculated its dimensional formula, lt minus 2. So kg we can write in terms of mass as m. So for m we are writing capital M as the dimension of mass, and the dimensions of A is lt minus 2. So the dimension of force is mlt minus 2. We have calculated it with the help of the formula F is equal to ma. Now suppose we have work, we have to find the dimensions of work. W is equal to F S. Now we have calculated the dimensions of force, so we are writing here M L T minus 2, and S is displacement here, and displacement is a length, so we can write into L. So collectively we can write this M L 2 T minus 2. This is the dimension of work. We have calculated this with the help of the formula F multiplied by displacement. Now since we know that work is a form of energy, so we can say the dimension of energy is also ml2t minus 2, energy, ml2t minus 2. Now we can calculate this with the help of other formulae. Suppose we have potential energy, and the formula for potential energy is mg multiplied by h. M is mass, so its dimension is m, g is acceleration, so we have calculated the dimension of acceleration as lt minus 2, and s is height. Height means length, so we can write l. So we can write m l2 t minus 2, that is the dimension of potential energy, or we can say that is the dimension of energy. So the work has the same dimension as that of the energy. Now we have one more formula for kinetic energy. Kinetic energy, half mv square. Now from this formula, ke is equal to, if we just, this is our constant, and constants have no dimensions. So the value 1 by 2 has no dimension, it is known as dimensionless. And the dimension of mass is m, and the dimension of v is lt minus 1, and power 2 is there. So we can write m l2 t minus 2. That is the dimension of kinetic energy. Now from the three formulas, we have W, MLT minus 2, energy in form of potential energy has the same dimension, and in form of kinetic energy it has the same dimension. So we have some limitations of dimensions. Limitations, here the quantity is work, here the quantity is energy, and the type of energy here is potential energy, and here kinetic energy. Now suppose if a quantity, if you have to answer the name of the physical quantity whose dimension is given ml2t minus 2, so on the basis of this dimension you can answer whether either it is work, potential energy, energy, kinetic energy, or any other physical quantity which has the same dimension. So the first drawback is more than one physical quantities have the same dimension, so it is difficult to identify the correct physical quantity with the help of given dimensional formula. This is the first drawback of dimensions. Second, the constants have no dimension. Suppose I write here k is given 1 by 2 mv square, and in place of 1 by 2 I write ke is equal to 5 by 7 mv square. So the both the formula are dimensionally correct, have the same value, If we derive it from the help of dimensions, both are dimensionally correct. But we know that the actual value of the constant in the formula kinetic energy is 1 by 2, but here 5 by 7 is written. So this formula, we know that this is incorrect. But according to dimension, both the formulae are correct. So this is the second drawback, that the physical quantities having constants, we do not have the dimensions of the constant quantities. Now till now we have studied how to find the dimensions of a physical quantity and two of its limitations. Now we have some applications. First application of dimension is to check the accuracy of a formula. Suppose we have a formula F is equal to MA, and we have to check whether this formula is dimensionally correct or not. So we will write LHS. LHS, force is given, and in RHS we have MA. So we know that the dimension of force, that is MLT-2. We have just calculated earlier. Now here the dimension of M is M and A, LT-2. So the dimensions of LHS and RHS are same. So we can write the formula is dimensionally correct. If we just write the formula is correct, maybe it may be wrong, but if it is better to write the formula is dimensionally correct, because on the basis of dimension, if the formula is correct, that doesn't mean the formula is actually a correct formula. Second, we have A is equal to V minus U upon T. This is the formula, and we have to find whether it is dimensionally correct or not. So we will write LHS here and RHS. In LHS, A is given and its dimension is LT-2, and in RHS we have V minus U upon T. So the dimension of T is clear, capital T. Now if we subtract, this one is final velocity, this one is initial velocity. If we subtract velocity from velocity, our resultant will be velocity. So we can write here, this one is velocity. So the dimensional formula of velocity is LT-1, and this T is for T. So the formula becomes LT-2. So both the formula are dimensionally correct. So we can say the formula is dimensionally a correct formula. Now suppose we are taking one more example. We have KE is equal to 5 by 7 MV square. So in place of kinetic energy, we know ML2T-2, that is the dimensional formula for energy in LHS. And in RHS, since the constant have no dimension, we write only MV square, and in place of M we can write M and LT-1 whole square, so it becomes ML2T-2. So we can say LHS is equal to RHS. Hence the formula is dimensionally correct. Now we know that KE is equal to half MV square. We all know this formula. So we know that this formula is incorrect in actual practice. But according to dimension, this formula is correct. So it is better to write, in place of the formula is correct, the formula is dimensionally correct. Now it is the first application of dimensions to check the accuracy of a formula dimensionally. Now till now we have studied about how to find dimensions of a physical quantity . Second, two limitations . Third one, to check the accuracy of a formula. In this segment, we have just studied about these three things. In next segment, we will just find how to convert one system of unit into another and how to derive a formula with the help of dimensions. Okay, that's all.
अभी 3 मिनट बाकी है।